Most COVID patients fully recover, but not all. Experts believe at least 10% of patients become COVID long haulers who suffer severe symptoms indefinitely after diagnosis. Heidi Ferrer, a well-known Hollywood screenwriter, was one of them. After fighting the virus for more than a year and experiencing endless setbacks, she died by suicide at the end of May. And her husband, Nick Guthe, joins us now. Nick, we're so sorry for your loss. I really appreciate you being here to share Heidi's story with us. And I know that that's what she wanted. I mean, the reason you're doing this interview is to get her story out. And so just tell us what her year was like and what her symptoms were like in her daily life.
Well, it started with excruciating, unexplained pain in her feet that we first thought was plantar fasciitis and turned out to be the equivalent of diabetic nerve pain, although she wasn't a diabetic, which made her bedridden by last June. And it followed incredibly difficult digestive issues for months, overall body aches, racing heart rate. When she would just get out of bed to walk, her heart would go from 80 to 130 beats in 15 seconds. And then neurological tremors that started in the last month that were very scary and also completely disrupted her sleep. She had like an internal vibration in her body that she could feel but nobody else could see, but kept her from sleeping. So for the last month, she barely slept more than an hour at a time.
It sounds horrible. I mean, it sounds like a living hell, obviously. And this went on for more than a year for her?
It started 13 months ago, yeah.
Were doctors ever able to determine or give you guys any explanation for why she had such a debilitating case?
No. I mean, in the beginning, the tests were so inaccurate, the early tests were so inaccurate that, you know, nobody would even say she had it. They came up with a bunch of other reasons and none of them seemed accurate. And she did get some more advanced tests later on that actually led her to be referred to the long haul COVID clinic at Cedars-Sinai, and the letter for a referral ironically arrived the day before she took her life. That's how hard it is to get people to pay attention to people with long haul COVID if they didn't get a positive test in the first, 8 weeks.
This disease, this illness is so cruel. It is so unpredictable. And I know that Heidi talked about that in her blog. And there were times during the past year, even this year, that she believed that she had turned a corner. And so one of her blog posts, January 25th, she said, "I have positive news. I'm cautiously optimistic that I'm still improving slowly but surely every month. I have had over 40 scary and even crippling long COVID symptoms in July. Now I'm down to a few frustrating ones, but so much better." And then what happened?
She was improving. She decided to get the Moderna vaccine March 8th, which she had been, a lot of long haulers felt could improve their symptoms. In her case, it had just the opposite effect. And I want to make clear, I'm 100% pro-vaccine. I'm vaccinated, my son is vaccinated. But in her case, it set her back to where she was last July and also led to the neurological tremors that were very scary, almost like Parkinsonian tremors that kept her up late at night and made sleeping impossible. And it was that last month, she had a brain fog that really came on very hard at the end and made even reading a book almost impossible to retain information. She loved to read, had 500 books on her Kindle, and I think that almost was the final straw for her when she couldn't even enjoy a book.
Yeah, I mean, I think that you've talked about that. When it deprives you of every single, not only life pleasure, but just life activity between eating, sleeping, reading, functioning, it just gets to be too much. And did she talk to you about what her plan was when things were at their darkest?
No, I mean, she had indicated that if things got really bad, she didn't know how she could continue. She didn't know how she could keep going. And I just kept saying, hang on. Medical science is moving at the quickest rate it ever has. We got a vaccine in a year. But I think she just felt, that she was only going to diminish. She was going to lose the ability to walk, end up in a wheelchair, not be able to bathe herself. And based on the video she left for us, she indicated she wanted to go out while she still had some, dignity, I guess. It's the best way I can explain it. I did ask her to hang on.
Nick, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry that this horrible illness robbed you of her and robbed, obviously, all of her friends and the community that she was in. And so she wanted you to get her story out. What's your message to our viewers?
Well, the message to people with long haul is, hang on. I believe that help is on the way, but we need our government to step in now and fund research right away and provide mental health support services for people like her. I am in contact with one of her friends on one of her support groups who told me the other day, literally 15 people messaged her separately within 24 hours to say they were thinking about taking the same route Heidi took. And that's just another person suffering with COVID who has to act as a de facto suicide counselor. And as she said to me, I'm not trained to do it. And she's battling herself. With this, the Washington government needs to step in now. If 3 million people out there have long haul COVID, as you said, one out of 10 people, there is a tsunami coming. And my wife was one of the first, unfortunately, and there probably will be more, but we need to pay attention. And it's not just about suicide, it's about people reentering the workforce. This is an economic issue. We have trained people, nurses, firemen, first responders, essential workers who are not going to be able to go back to their jobs because they are exhausted, they're bedridden. As my wife said to me many times, I don't know what I would do if I was a single mother. I don't know how I could function. I as the husband, I had to pick up all the slack of cooking, cleaning, shopping, and I was happy to do it. I said to her every day, you on the couch is enough for us. You on the couch, just hang on. And I wish that the medical community would have taken long haul COVID more seriously early on, and maybe the therapeutics would have been here and maybe she'd still be here.
Yeah. Nick, we hear your call. It's totally reasonable to ask for those things. And as you point out, there are all the symptoms that we can't see in terms of mental health that we all need to be attuned to. Nick Guthe, we're really sorry for your loss. Thanks so much for sharing Heidi's story. I think it will help people.
Thanks for having me.
If you or someone you know may be at the risk of suicide, please call the National Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-8255. They are there to talk to you now. We'll be right back.